Hello dear friends, my name is Dr. Mohammad Aminul Islam. Welcome to my channel. In my previous video, I explained what is indicator and how to choose suitable indicator for titration of strong acid with strong base. In this video, I would like to show you how to choose suitable indicator for titration of weak acid versus strong base. This video is very important, so please do not skip. Well, there are four types of acid-base titration. One is strong acid versus strong base, which has been explained in my previous videos. Then strong acid versus weak base. Then weak acid versus strong base. For example, oxalic acid versus sodium hydroxide, phenolphthalein suitable. So I will explain this in this video. Then weak acid versus weak base. Well, here is an example of weak acid versus strong base. Then acid base indicators. From this indicator list, we see that phenolphthalein working pH range is 8.2 to 10, while second range of thymol flow is 8 to 9.6. And some indicators exhibit more than one color. Then pH neutralization curve. Here is the pH neutralization curve for titration of oxalic acid with sodium hydroxide. And phenolphthalein working pH range is this and thymol flow is this. So from pH neutralization curve, we see that the vertical line of the curve is within the region of 8 to 10. So phenolphthalein and thymol flow can be used for this type of titration. Therefore, major takeaway is if working pH range of an indicator falls within the region of vertical line of pH curve, then it is suitable indicator for that type of titration. For weak acid versus strong base, phenolphthalein and thymol flow is within the vertical line of pH neutralization curve. Therefore, phenolphthalein and thymol flow are suitable indicators for titration of weak acid with strong base. In my next video, I will show you the suitable indicator for titration of strong acid weak base and weak acid weak base. Thanks for watching.